Nothing's happening. I can shake it. Still nothing comes out. That is so annoying. Hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's Best in Beauty from, I don't know, Fail to Holy Grail. Yes. And I'm feeling very, very spooky as well. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love to be dramatic, like me, if you are fabulous, like me, and we all are fabulous, like me, if you want to be entertained, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and if you want to play my Halloweeny band, then this is the channel for you. Make sure to subscribe, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Yes, we are starting a Halloweeny band because I'm slightly orcish. That means olive. So if you are olive, you're slightly orcish as well. And we already have some pale elves. We have some mummies. We have some uncooked chickens. We have Fiona's to our Shrek. We have a lot of ghoulish people here, but we need more. So you can play any instrument you want. Just saying. Today, I'm very dramatic. I usually am dramatic, but today I'm extra dramatic because of the whole vibe I have going on. Yes. So the Best of Beauty, what kind of does that video entail? It's basically all the products that I tried in a month, I'm going to put in a tier system for you. I have 5 tiers. I have a hell no. Kind of says it all, right? Then I have meh, and in that are products that are okay, that are not bad, but they're, you know, they're meh. What can I say? They're meh. Then we have these are nice. That means they're good products. You know, quality is good. It's just, they're just good products. They're nice. Very, very nice, you know? And then we have number 4 is, oh my God, these are good. Yes, then the last one is kind of my favorite. You have to pry it out of my cold, dead hands, aka I want to be buried with this shiz. Yeah, those are the 5 tiers. They are not really ranked, but they're kind of ranked. Some products are a little bit in the middle. They are, yeah, let's just get into it. Okay, I have 2, oh hell no, products. And the first one that I'm going to mention was actually a gift with purchase. It's from NYX. It's their Strictly Vinyl eyeliner in purple. Now I was so excited to try this, and then I wanted to try it. Where is it? Oh yeah, it's here. There. This is what. Nothing's happening. I can shake it. Still nothing comes out. I know what I said. So I don't know. It's, I think it, maybe it's an old product. I don't know what's going on, but it just doesn't function. So it's, I'm, why does it smell of cocoa? Huh. I think I'm just going to be on the safe side and toss it, which is kind of sad because I really wanted to try this. But yeah, that's why you never saw it on video, because it didn't do anything. Then the next product that I have is technically not, it's not a terrible product. I just feel like it doesn't do anything for me. And that is from, I got this actually as a gift from LA Girl. It's the Matte Base Anti-Feathering. I just feel like it doesn't do anything for me. And now lip liners that I really, really love are the ones from, for instance, the ones from Catrice, which are a little bit plumping. I really like that. And this, I feel it just, it doesn't dry out my lips. So in that it functions. So if I want to use a liquid lipstick, I can use this underneath to stop my lips from really drying out. But for the rest, I just don't, I kind of forget that I have it. So yeah, so sorry. I'm sorry. Those are the bad products that I have this month. Then the next one, next category is the Mwah category. And in this are products that are, they are not bad products, but for me, they are meh. And let's start with the first one, which is from also a present, unfortunately. This is from, what is it, Dollface Beauty. It's the Blot & Blur Pressed Powder. Now, I have to explain this. I have tried it because the embossing is already gone. I am just not a pressed setting powder type of person, apparently right now. I don't know, I just felt that when I tried it in summer, and we did not have a very, very hot summer, so it was basically kind of warm-ish. I don't know, I felt like it didn't do enough for me. And when it did do enough for me, I had to kind of cake it on. Does that make any sense? So I do like it to use to buff out my eyeshadow, for instance. That's how I use a pressed powder. I just prefer a loose powder for setting my face. So that's it. Yes. Then the next one that I'm going to mention is from Pacifica, also present. It's the Dream Big Mascara. Now, I have to explain this. Is this a bad mascara? No. It's a bit of a drier formula. You can kind of play with the wand a little bit. Yes, I know. It's apparently that type of video. If you twist the knob, it gets longer or shorter. Yes, I know what I said. I know where your mind is going. Mine is going there as well. Let's just... It's okay. It's okay. It's a safe place here. But basically, I have one mascara that I use. I have one mascara that I love because I wear falses usually. So the mascara that I have, it's a tube mascara. It's from Essence. It's the Bye Bye Panda Eyes. It's amazing. When I tried this with my falses and it makes my lashes nice and black. That's cool. When I tried without my falses though, it doesn't do enough for me, so that's why it is in the meh category. I'm just apparently very particular with my mascara. What can I say? Then the next product is going to be an eyeliner, which was also a present. This is from Winky Lux. This is their cat eye. I don't know, it the letters already have rubbed off. Now, this is not a bad product at all. It's just not waterproof. So while I really like the formula, I like the way that it applies. It's not a brush tip. I kind of prefer a brush tip a little bit, but that's okay. You can shake it up. It's a very, very nice eyeliner. It's just not waterproof, and I need a waterproof. So I use this on days where I am filming. So I'm filming looks back to back, and I need an eyeliner, but not a waterproof one. Then I grab this because, yeah, again, it's a very, very nice one. It's just for what I want. I need a waterproof one. Dutch Coast, we have a lot of rain here. I need a waterproof eyeliner. So that's the reason that it is in the meh category. If you don't mind that though, I think you will really like this one. Then the next thing that I'm going to mention is also a pressed powder. This is also from Dollface. This is the All A Glow powder. And this is preference also, honestly. It's very pretty. It's a yellowy powder. I can kind of use it as a very nice light sheen. I can use it as a buffing powder as well. I can also use it to set underneath my eyes. But for setting underneath my eyes, I do like a glowing powder, but this one is a little bit too shiny for me. So there is a little bit too much, almost pearlescent, for me to use as a setting powder underneath my eyes. If I use it as a buffing powder, I can. I just also feel that it emphasizes my pores more, because in this particular powder there is, as I said, kind of a pearlescent.
Really? Come here. Oh, no, thank you. Thank you. Where did I put you? I put you here. Yes.
So you can kind of see it here, I think. And maybe it's also a skin tone thing, because this, I have it here. Yes, I have it here. So it has a very, very nice shine. But because I am slightly orcish, an olive-y, it almost stands out a little bit more. Maybe it's a little bit too icy. It could be that. It's a very, very nice powder. But for what I like to use, at least now, this ain't it. I think that I will like it more in winter, because in winter I use more matte foundations. Don't ask me why, I don't know, but it is what it is. I actually think that I will like it, this one, if I use my Fenty foundation, because that's a very matte foundation. So I will keep on trying this and I will keep on using it. But it's just not my preference. I think that's a better explanation. So again, not a bad powder. It's just not my preference. Then the next product, the last one in this category, is a product that I'm kind of having a love-hate relationship with. This is a product that I have been trying out for 2 months, and sometimes I'm like, it doesn't do anything. Other times I'm like, it is the best product in the world. Then it makes my brows shiny, then it doesn't. I don't know. So that's why it's here. I do want to talk about it because maybe you have tips for me. It's this one. It's the NYX, the brow glue. I have it in my brows today. I feel like it's not doing anything again today. I don't know why. Sometimes it does. I think that I will. I do like it when I am, when I don't have any foundation on, but I do want to do my brows. I don't know. I heard Angelica rave about this because for her it keeps her brows in place. Maybe mine are too rambunctious. I don't know. I need mine literally cemented to my head. This doesn't do that. So, okay, then I was like, maybe I kind of need to change up my brow routine. So I'm doing that as well. And then it's still, I don't know. I do feel kind of that it separates my hairs a little bit, but I don't. A lot of the time it just is just not it. Does that make any sense? Other times I'm like, it's amazing. I don't know. Also today my brows are apparently very, this one is in werewolf mode and this is like, I don't want to play today. I don't know. If you have this, let me know. I don't really know. I feel like it doesn't, I feel like it's more of a, almost a wax, like a hair wax, that one that doesn't dry down. I kind of feel like that, and I need something that dries down, so I don't know. That's why it's here, because I really don't know what to make of this product. So yeah, that's why it's there. Okay, the next category is nice. And I kind of have to explain the first product, because while I think that the quality is good, it is not as amazing as I kind of had envisioned it to be. And that is the Glamlight formula. So I have here the Glamlight Makeup Palette. I have played with it a few times. The shimmers are stunning. Honestly, I love the color story, hence why I bought it. The shimmers are stunning. Stunning. The mattes are, I like the mattes, but they are not as amazing as I thought in my head that they should be. Yes, it could also be preference. It could be the eyeshadow base. I have tried it with my Natasha Denona base, and that's my favorite base right now. And then it's a little bit better, but I don't know. I feel like maybe it's a little bit overhyped. So that's why it's in the, it's good, because the shimmers are amazeballs. The mattes, yeah, they're good. They're, you know, they didn't blow me away. Let's say that. Also, I prefer to go from lighter to darker. I'm not a pack on blend out kind of girl. Maybe that's the difference as well. I don't know, but I do want to try more from Glamlight, but this particular palette is, I don't know, I think I had it hyped up too much in my head. I think that's it. Okay, let's go to the next thing, which is also in this category, but a little bit on the lower side of the nice. And that is from Bitter Lace Beauty. It's a highlighter. Now, the formula is amazing. If you want to shine to the gods, this is the formula that you need. This is purely a color thing. While I really, I don't even know if I can show it to you. It has different colors. This is the shade Life is Bubbles. It has different colors in there. I think you can see it when I do this. The downside is with this one, it is so icy that if I put it on as a highlighter, you see a white stripe. It's just too icy for my liking. In a corner work though, oh ho 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 ho. Yeah. So here it is. Can you see? It's too icy for what I usually go for. But for inner corner, oh my lord. I have another one from Bitter Lace Beauty in my inner corner right now. But yeah, so while I think that the formula is amazing, this is just purely a color thing. So the next product that I'm going to mention is a product that I do use every day, but I feel like I can get better. And let me explain that. It's a brow powder. It's from Catrice. It's actually their eyebrow set, which is powders. And then you get a very eeny, meeny, tiny tweezer and brushes. And this is the color. Now, the colors are very, very nice and cool toned. So you can create a nice shadow. Color-wise, for my brows, especially with my hair being the way that it is right now, it is too brown, but that's okay. I feel, though, that this powder is maybe a little bit too soft. Because I almost want to have a powder that's a little bit stiffer, that when I put it on my brow, you can kind of see what is happening here. It's basically, it's not really staying put. And I think that that is what I'm looking for. So I think that I'm looking for a brow powder. I had it when I used my Nomad eyeshadow for brow powder. I could kind of blend it into my brows, but it kind of stayed put at the same time. And this, I feel, is almost too soft. Maybe even a little bit too powdery. Sometimes you have that with eyeshadow as well, right? That you put it on your eye, you do one swipe and it's woof. You kind of feel like you blend it away. I kind of feel the same way with this. So that's why it's here in the it's in the nice category. A little bit lower than nice, but not in the next category. So I think it's a good powder. I think the colors are good. I just think that formula-wise, I prefer something that's maybe a little bit stiffer. I have another brow powder here from BB, this one. I feel this one is a little bit more of a stiffer formula almost. So, but correct me if I'm wrong down in the comment sections, because I have no idea. The next product that I'm going to mention is Lippy. And this was also a gift. This is from the Lip Bar in the shade Extra. And this is a lip gloss that is brown. It goes very well with my nails, but it has a sparkly in it. And it's just so pretty. I also love the component. Now, the reason that it is not in the oh my god, this is good, is just it's a gloss. And I am very, very particular with my glosses. This gloss is a little bit of a stickier formula, which I really do like, and I love the color. It's kind of on the cusp, you know, of it's actually better than nice. It's better than nice, and it's a little bit under oh my god, this is freaking amazeballs. This is a very, very good gloss. Let's just say that. It's a very good gloss. Then the last product that I have in this category, which is the... This is very nice category. It's a palette that I played with recently. And I was very, very happily impressed. And it's the Joker palette from Makeup Revolution. Now, the reason that it is here and it's not high is because the depth... And when I did the look, I used... almost all the shades. I did not use the very light one and I did not use the blue. For the rest, I used everything. However, for what I wanted to create, I had to pull in a black from another palette. And that is the reason that it is here and not in the next category. Because I think that this is a very, very, very nice quality. I was very impressed. I was very impressed with the yellow. I was very impressed by the light green. It's just that... Yeah, I actually would have loved a black in here. Hell, it could even have been a black shimmer. That would actually be very cool if there was a true black shimmer in here. Yeah, it would be very, very nice. This one, yeah, this one could have been a shimmer as well for inner corner. But that's the reason it's not higher. Just because for my preference, I couldn't get the depth that I was looking for in combination with the darker shimmers that are in the palette. I think that's the best explanation that I can give. But I really, really like this quality. Very, very nice. Yes. The reason that this product is not in the next one is purely the applicator. This is the Freckle Tint from Boozy Shop. Now, if you have been with me a little while longer, you may know that the Freckle Tint from Freck, is my favorite color Freckle Tint, especially in summer. This is a very, very close dupe. But at the fraction of the cost. The reason that it's here is the applicator. I prefer a brush applicator. And this is a silicone tip applicator. So when I kind of use it, I don't know. I feel like, can you see what it is doing? That. When I have a brush, I feel like I can... I don't know. I feel like I have... I prefer a brush. That's the reason. That's the reason that it is here. I love the color. I have it on today. I kind of combined it with Freck today. I just prefer a different applicator. That is it. It's the only reason. Yes. Okay, next is the category, oh my god, these are good. And this is just a step below, I need to be buried with this. So these are my favorite products, but they are not my holy grail products. Maybe that is it? I don't know. Let's go to the first thing, which is from Bitter Lace Beauty again. It's the other highlighter. This is the Happily Ever After. I have that in my inner corner today. And I think this is, again, a stunning, stunning formula. I can kind of show you. If I use... Fortunately for me, I can really nicely blend this out. But I use this one more often than the other one. So that's why it is higher. And then when I blend it out correctly, it's very, very nice. Very nice. Does it emphasize texture? A tiny bit, but not a lot. So yeah, that's why this one is higher. Now again, the quality is so, so nice. The colors are so, so interesting. And this one has a little bit of a blueiness in it. So when I do, for instance, a cooler toned look, I can really nicely pull this in. That's why this one is higher. Then the next thing I'm going to go to is a palette. Yes, and it's from VE Cosmetics. It's the Kitchen Witch palette. This is so, so fun. This is such a nice color story. It's a very, very nice quality. I love the fact that you can go monochromatic. You can, you know, mix and match. You can do an everyday neutrally look with the brown and the orange. You can do a green brown and then with a pop of orange. And the quality is very, very nice as well. It's the VE Cosmetics quality. I did buy this one myself. Do I have PR? I do have PR, but that's a little bit further down the line. I do have a discount code with VE Cosmetics if you want to save some money. It's not affiliated, but it will save you 10%. Yes, I really, really like that color story a lot. The next one that I'm going to go to is also an eyeshadow palette. The reason that this is a little bit higher than the VE Cosmetics one is because I have more options. It's this one. It's the Be Perfect Carnival palette. This is a palette that I love. I love. You get a lot of options. It's not in the next category just because what I have in the next category I want to be buried with. And this is a very, very nice, and I want to keep it in my collection, but I don't necessarily have to be buried with this palette. Does that make any sense at all? I don't know. I think that the quality is very, very good in this. I had a lot of fun. I created 10 looks. I think they all came out beautifully. You know, you have your greener side, you have your redder side, you have a little bit of more, I don't know, neutrally thing going on in the middle. You can do so much with this palette. It's just, honestly, I truly had a lot of fun creating all the looks with the Antidote palette. Yes. Then I am going to go to another product that I have from VE Cosmetics. What are these called again? These are the Magical Essence things. This is in the shade Love is Always the Answer. And this you can use as a liner. It's actually a liquid eyeshadow that you can all, well, use as a liquid eyeshadow. You can use it as an eyeliner. You can also use it on your lips. That's usually how I use this, as a colored eyeliner or funky eyeliner and on my lips. And I've tried this on top of different liquid lipsticks. It's stunning. It's stunning and it's also fun to play with. It's very, very pretty. So how do I use this? I pick up for an eyeliner, I just use an angled brush and I pick up from the wand. If I use it on my lips, I put it on the back of my hand, a dollop, and I pick it with a brush up from there. Now you can kind of see it's almost... Can you kind of see the... I could have used it today. There's so much in there color wise. Now the reason that it is not one that I want to be buried with is because the one that I want to be buried with probably is on its way to me, because I ordered that one. I love this color though, and I think it's just very, very fun to play with. I think the products are, yeah, I think they're amazing. She has so many colors, truly. So the next product that I have in this category, which is basically the reason that it's not in the next category, is just, well, I really, really love this product. If I ran out, I can kind of wait a little while before I buy another one. Does that make any sense? That was kind of, I have to give myself a criteria. And this is from Boomy Organic Beauty. This is the face oil, pomegranate, hemp, rosehip, and wheat germ. I really do love this oil. I love face oils in general. But yeah, as I said, I love it. But when I kind of run out of this, it's not that I am almost in a panic attack because I'm running out. Does that make any sense? I have other oils that I love as well. This is, though, one of my favorite oils. It smells like ingredients. She makes everything in small batches. And I don't know, I really like the aesthetic. And I really do love this oil. It's an oil that I use very, very frequently. Not specifically every day, but very, very frequently. Yeah, I really do love this one. Yes. The next product is a product that the only reason that it's not in the next category is because it's leaking. This was also a gift. This is from Profusion. This is the Juicy Lip Tint. Now you can kind of see how much I have used, right? I love this lip oil. However, it leaks. So that's the reason that it is not higher. And I don't know why. It's closed, but I cannot close it anymore. It keeps on leaking. I have to have it on something. That is so annoying. So the packaging, I do not like because it leaks. But the product, I really, really love this lip oil. Juicy lip tint. I don't know. Does it give my lips a tint? I have no idea. But I really, really love this lip oil. It is a... I don't know how to explain it. It's just a very nice hydrating oil. It's a little bit sticky. It has a nice smell. You cannot see it here. It has a little bit of an orangey tint. I adore this lip oil, but I detest the packaging. That's why it's here. Okay, then I'm going to go to the category. You have to pry this out of my cold, dead hands. I want to be buried with this. Yes, I cannot rank these. These are equal, basically. But let's start with gifts. Because you have not seen these on my channel yet, because I haven't filmed, or maybe you have, depending on if the haul goes up before this one. But I got something from one of you, and these I want to be buried with. They're glow in the dark, and they're just too cute. It's these. It's ghost sponges. These are from Base Blue Cosmetics. Now, Base Blue Cosmetics, unfortunately, does not ship outside of the USA. Or maybe Canada. USA and Canada. I don't know. They don't ship to me. One of you saw my video where I talked about these and sent me two. And I am so, so grateful because these made my day when they came in. They are glow-in-the-dark, ghosty makeup sponges that will not be used ever. These sit there and these are going to go with me in my grave. Because they are just the cutest. The cutest. Honestly. So yeah. I told you I was dramatic today. They can go back to their house. Can you see them there? They're just too cute. Okay. And then. Let's leave you for last. Then I'm going to go to. Am I cheating? Yes. Why? Because I don't want to rank these palettes. Yes, it's palettes. Yes, it's a kind of a collection. I got this in PR. I don't want to rank them in this video. Because I want to save that for my ranking my latest, I don't know, bunch of palettes. So I am going to tier them and group them as one. And it is from Odin's Eye. It's the Diversa collection. Now, if you don't know, Odin's Eye Cosmetics is a Swedish-based indie brand. They focus on Norse and Germanic mythology. And they have collabed with three amazing creators here on YouTube. And I will show the palettes to you. So the first palette is the Giant Wolves palette, which is in collaboration with Annette from Annette's Makeup Corner. This is her to a T. And the quality is amazing. Amazing. Yeah. Then the next palette is the Hummingbird palette. And that is in collaboration with Tina. And her channel name is The Fancy Face. Very, very fun and colorful palette. This one is shimmer heavy. And yeah, but a very, very, very stunning palette. Quality-wise, they are all equal. It's the best formula that Odin's Eye has ever done. That's it. Then the last one is in collab with Judy. And this is the Red Dragon palette. And this is what it looks like. And I had so much fun with all the palettes. They are just stunning. And I have done a video reviewing the entire collection. If there is a palette that you like, don't worry that it is shitty quality, because it's not. It's honestly so, so good. Then the next palette that I'm going to mention is also PR. And maybe you have guessed the palette that I'm going to mention. It is from Nomad Cosmetics, the Haunted Europe palette. Can we just appreciate the artwork? Also, what I forgot to mention is that part of the proceeds of this palette go to a bat conservation program, just so you know. But here is the color story. This was PR. I have done a video, 5 looks in the video. And this is just, it's just such a yummy palette. You know, you can go, here you can go very nice and neutral, and then with this kind of a grayer shade, oh, the combination between gray and that yellow, we got, it's stunning. Then here you have your cooler part with your green and a little bit of blue, and then here orangey, pinky. You can go row by row if you want to. You can kind of go a little bit monochromatic, maybe you can mix and match. If you want some inspiration, go watch my video. And there, if you want to know how it looks on a deeper skin tone, there are a few creators here on the platform that have gotten this palette as well, that have done videos with it. I know that DJ from Just PGD has done swatching. I will leave a bunch of channels down below where you can go to for inspiration with this palette. It's just, I love it. I love it, I love it. If you want to know more thoughts, go watch my video. And then the last product that I have in today's video is another skincare product. And this product, I think I love the most out of everything that I have here. If I am almost close to running out, I need a new one. This is also from Boomy, and this is the moisturizer. This is the Night Repair Broccoli and Cucumber Moisturizer. This is the color. This feels so luxurious on your skin. Let me get a tiny bit. You can use a tiny bit, you can use a lot. It's, can you see? It's just so, it feels so nice. It feels so luxe. It feels, what I use a cleansing balm. And what I love about a cleansing balm is that when you put it on your face and then it basically, it melts, you know? This is the same thing, it melts. And it's just so nice to rub over your face. Honestly, ever since I got this product, I kind of like doing my skincare anyway. But now I'm really looking forward to when I can take off my makeup and put that cream on. Because, oh, it's just so nice. It smells of ingredients. I don't think it stinks, but it does not smell of roses. Because there are no roses in there. It smells of, I don't know, a little bit, I won't say herby. I don't know if that's the correct term. But when I use this, even if I slather it on, which I sometimes do, when I wake up in the morning, it sinks into my skin, except here. Because here is a part where it's pretty thin, you know. Then usually I have a little bit here left that I can kind of smear down my face again. I love this cream so, so much. And I think this is the small size. So you can also get a bigger one. You can use this if you have very, very dry legs. I think you can use this on your legs. Yeah, you can use this on your legs as well. It's just such a, oh, it feels so, so nice. So yeah, I think that was it. That was it for me today. Let me know if you have any of the products. Let me know if you agree with my findings. Do you have any tips or tricks? Let me know. Oh, did I tell you what I have on my eyeballs? I don't know if I did. It's the Grimoire from VE Cosmetics. I'm filming with the Grimoire right now. That's why it's not in this video, because I have not formed my opinion on it yet. This is the first look and I really like it. So yeah, thank you so, so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.